I would call upon this next group to help me out. As you know, director James Gunn announced in February that filming had wrapped for the Suicide Squad. And right now, he's taken a break from the edit bay to be here with us to discuss his vision for the film, answer fan questions, and have some insanely crazy fun with the cast. And, of course, share some never-before-seen content with us. Check it out.
This is amazing. I'm so excited to be here at DC Fandome with all the amazing DC fans. As many of you know, The Suicide Squad is by far the most fun I've ever had making a movie. I am still working hard on it every day from morning till night, but we're having a great time creating something incredibly special for people. And I'd like to take this break now to take some questions from you guys.
Hey, James. When was the first time you ever read Suicide Squad as a comic book? And who was your favorite character?
I read Jon Ostrander's original run of Suicide Squad. So I remember reading the very first issue of that run and falling in love with the concept, with the characters. I loved the movie The Dirty Dozen that came out back in the 60s. And this was like a super villain version of The Dirty Dozen. And I loved the character of Amanda Waller, who was so different for the time, you know, in terms of being such a strong woman, but not kind of an anti-hero, but kind of bad, kind of good, not physically the same as everybody else you saw in comic books. And I just thought she was so cool. And of course, I loved all the characters and Boomer and everybody. And I just had a great time reading that initial run.
My name is Maisha Kondekar, and I'm a loyal DC fan, and I'm making this video from Dhaka, Bangladesh. I have a question for James Gunn. Which DC character were you most excited to write about for the Suicide Squad movie, and why?
Maisha, I think the character that I was the most excited to write for was Harley Quinn. I've loved this character ever since Paul Dini first put her in animated shows. I think that there's a sort of chaotic trickster god nature to her, where she's just always going off in random directions. And as a writer, that's a really fun thing to deal with because she takes you in places where you don't know you're going to go. So a lot of it was me writing for Harley, and a lot of it was Harley doing some of the writing for me during the Suicide Squad.
Hey, I'm Jay from State Farm, and setting aside the massive amounts of damage that you must have had the squad rack up in that one scene, can you confirm the number of crashes and explosions? You know, asking for a friend.
Hey, Jake, I cannot confirm the exact amount of explosions and crashes, but I will say that we have about as many explosions and crashes in this film as in any film ever. In fact, the guy who did all of our special effects on this film, Dan Sudik, who has done almost all of the Marvel movies, great movies, says that there are more effects in this film than all of those movies he's done combined. So we have quite a huge special effect explosion extravaganza for you guys.
You've said Ostrander's run was influential, but what else inspired you to feature these under the radar characters?
That is an amazing question, and one I'm excited to answer, because I actually had a long talk with Jon Ostrander you know, about this, because he came and he visited the set, and I said, I don't think of this movie so much as an adaptation of your comics. I think of this movie as a sequel to your comics, to your run in the comic books. What would Jon Ostrander be doing with these characters, you know, if it was 30 years after he first started? And so I think that it has the spirit and the lifeblood of the Ostrander books, but I also like to continuously take in new supervillains, other supervillains who have sometimes been in the Suicide Squad comics over the years, but also a lot of, you know, characters like Polka Dot Man and Ratcatcher, who have never been in the Suicide Squad, but who I just think are great DC villains who have something to offer and that we could have put into the movie. So that is where my biggest inspiration comes from.
Who were your favorite villains as a kid? And did working on this movie teach you anything new about these quote-unquote villains?
Wow, who were my favorite villains growing up? Well, I was a huge Batman fan, and I'm going to tell you who my favorite villain was. And maybe it's a little embarrassing, but I'm not embarrassed by it. It was Batmite. I loved Batmite. I thought he was hilarious and creepy as heck. So Batmite was definitely my favorite supervillain. And don't think I didn't think about putting the Batmite in the Suicide Squad, because I did.
I saw the set photos of the Suicide Squad, and I absolutely love the direction of the movie. But is it true that Flora Borg is playing Javelin Man? And if so, why? Also, is Nathan Fillion playing Blackguard?
Hey, Milan, so, is Flula playing Javelin Man? Well, his name isn't exactly Javelin Man, but in mere moments, we are going to see who Flula and Nathan are playing in the film. And I'll give you a hint. One of them you got pretty correct, and the other one you didn't get correct. And there's a lot of people all over the internet who have theories about who people are playing, and sometimes they've been right, and sometimes they've been wrong. And so I guess we're going to answer all those questions in a minute. But I will tell you one thing, which is Flula Borg is the funniest guy in the entire world and incredibly strange. But he's become a good friend through all this, and he's a great guy. And Nathan, of course, has been in all my movies. He's already been a friend. Here it comes, the time that so many of you guys have been waiting for. Who is who in the squad? You've heard a lot of the actors that are in this movie. You don't know who they're playing. Maybe you have some good guesses. Maybe you're right. Maybe you're wrong. We'll have to see. But here it is, everything.
You know the deal. Successfully complete the mission, you get 10 years off your sentence.
You're my dream, you're my nightmare. Life is a dream, you don't fight fair.
Welcome, Task Force X. These are your brothers and sisters for the next few days.
Break away from the pain, I don't care. Cause I think I need some guy. No, she's don't stand a chance.
How is this going to work as a movie?
Juan Diego Boco is General Presidente Silvio Luna. Real great guy. Joel Kinnaman is, of course, Rick Flagg. Viola Davis is Amanda Waller. And, of course, Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn.
Hey, everybody.
All here. Together again.
Get together.
Good.
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 Are you excited to be a part of DC fandom?
Super excited. This is gonna be great.
Well, we're gonna have some fun here. We're gonna have some competition, which it's not fun unless there's somebody winning and somebody losing. And so I would like to have a couple of team leaders, and I think it only makes sense that we have the people in charge of the Suicide Squad, Viola Davis and Joel Kinnaman, as our team leaders.
Hey, team leaders.
Why don't you guys go ahead and let's pick teams.
Bloodsport.
Thanks, Bart. Thanks.
Definitely.
All right, I'll take my girl, Harley Quinn.
Yay. All right.
Yay.
I will take Savant.
Oh, good for you. Wow. What a bad mistake.
That is a bad pick. That is. And you guys have scenes together, too. I can't believe you made that mistake.
I tell you, you just made a big mistake.
John Cena. I'll take John Cena.
I want to reassure you that that is a horrible decision.
I already know
that. I'm going to take my boy, King Shark.
Okay, I will take my man Boomer, Jai Courtney.
Yeah. All right.
Rat Catcher.
Yes. Rat Catcher.
Rat Catcher 2.
Two.
I will take Flula Borg, the javelin.
Yes. Yeah. I guarantee we will lose. Yes.
I'm going to take Polka Dot Man.
Thank you.
Yes.
I'm gonna have to grab the weasel.
Oh, good man.
That's not on Rooker's team. Yes.
The weasel. Yes.
Is that everybody?
Not a name.
What about the weasel?
Makes me feel really bad.
Okay. There's left.
There's only so one sad. Left.
It feels like high school again.
It totally feels like high school.
This is what it was like. The basketball.
Yeah, the thinker.
Great idea.
Hey. I will pick the thinker.
Nathan Fillion
already.
DJ.
Woo. So sorry.
El Presidente. El Presidente.
Okay.
What about Mongo?
He got picked by Joel.
Yeah, thank you, Joel.
I'll just watch.
Pete, this is sad. Victory cigarette.
Oh, man. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I was going to pick Black Dart. Okay.
That went well. I think that went really well.
And then let's start off. We're going to go head to head, and we're going to start off with the team captains. Let's do Joel and Viola.
It's 27 characters.
This is a good question.
Okay.
Because I know both of you have know so much. Had their own comic series. There's two of them. And I'm going to list four options. A, Harley Quinn and King Shark. B, Harley Quinn and Amanda Waller.
18 characters
C,
in this film.
Harley Quinn and Peacemaker. Or D, Harley Quinn and Boomerang. Which two have had their own series?
Well, we know it's Harley Quinn.
Harley Quinn and Peacemaker.
Boom! Yes!
Yes!
Yes. Correct!
Oh, wow!
Even I knew that.
Man, it'd be awesome if it was, though.
Polka Dot Man!
Against?
Mr. Sean Gunn.
Weasel versus Polka Dot Man. Old friends.
Oh, I want a softball.
Oh, yeah, you have a special guest.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Hola. ¿Cómo están? How are you? I've got a question. What career military man probably wishes he'd never followed in his dad's footsteps?
Joaquin, the great Coachy Loco!
Rick Flagg Jr.
I had Super Grover. Is Super Grover... It's not Super Grover.
You're wrong, Sean. You're wrong. Wrong canon.
Points for creativity.
Now, there's no multiple choice. You just got to answer right away, and you have to have it be the right choice.
Okay.
Who has more tattoos, Harley Quinn or Pete Davidson?
Harley Quinn? No.
Pete, Margo gets another point.
I was thinking about his his character. Oh,
that's always your answer
when something goes wrong.
Who's next?
The Bond.
Fillion, TDK.
What is the government's official code name for the Suicide Squad?
I
thought it was the Suicide Squad.
Mayling's dying over there.
There's extremely.
Task Force X.
Task Force X. I can't say that even if I knew the answer.
You said it. Task Force X. You say it in the movie. Some of these are too easy. Hey, can we go? Can we go to like one of our secret guest questions?
Hey guys. Which team member would you sacrifice first?
Rooker. Correct answer.
Rooker.
Yeah.
You are you serious?
Is that what you said, Steve?
That's what I said.
What's the answer, what? Jen?
I would have to go with Savant because he's played by Michael Rooker. And if anyone here has ever had to spend a day working with Michael Rooker, I think they'd probably have the same answer.
You know what? People are always like that. They always want to get rid of the most dangerous one first. Yeah, I understand where this is coming from.
All right, we're going to have Flula versus Elise. Oh, boy! Which character made his or her first full appearance in Superboy number 9 in 1994? A, Mongal. B, King Shark. C, Bloodsport. D, The Thinker.
May I ask a question, Mr. Gunn?
Oh, no. Yeah.
When you say full appearance, does this mean like everything was exposed? Is it...
The character was not fully exposed. No, the character had some items of clothing on.
Got it. Then I would answer King Sharky.
I was going to say B.
B, King Shark. How did you guys know that?
No. Oh, I said King Sharky. That's incorrect. So
it goes to Elise.
Yeah, sorry. Jeopardy rules, guys. Pronounce it right.
Like not even crushing it.
Wait, he doesn't get that?
You can't just give away the point.
What? You can fool. You can't give away your point, dude.
Why not? I give away snacks at lunch. Have my point.
Hey.
Even on your team?
Yeah, Flula's on my team.
No, what are we doing right now? What's
he's
happening?
Not. He's not. You keep complaining.
He's not on our team. Oh, never mind.
When quiz night goes wrong. Yep. This is the experience of Zoom quizzing all over the world in 2020 right now.
Okay.
Reflected here in this
special question. Quiz. Why don't we do the last God. Question?
Ooh. Hi, guys. So now I have a serious question for you guys. I'm going to test your smarts. Who shot Superman? Was it G.R. Ewing, Peacemaker, Bloodsport, Amanda Waller? Let me know.
That is Storm Reid.
My daughter.
Which of your characters is in prison for shooting Superman?
Bloodsport.
That's correct. Bloodsport is in prison for shooting Superman.
That is a decent thing
Storm
to be
Reid
in prison
turns in
for.
An amazing performance in the film and some of the most memorable scenes. Like, really, she's like amazing in the movie. Really, wow. Truly.
What movie is that?
Oh my God.
Is there anybody left? Pete, who's left?
Blackguard.
Against two.
Lula.
Oh, great!
Oh, okay. Lula.
Who will lose first, Pete?
What comic book series did the Suicide Squad debut in? A, The Brave and the Bold. B, The Bold and the Beautiful. C, The Bravest of the Bold, or D, Time to Die Hard.
Yeah. Brave and the Bold.
Brave and the Bold.
Pete, it's yours.
Pete, you did it!
Oh, wait. Idris Elba, Bloodsport, versus Mei Ling, Mongal. Okay, question. Which character... Oh, this isn't fair. Oh, well. Question. Which character goes into the mission armed with the most... weaponry.
Bloodsport.
Mm-hmm. Oh, isn't it Polka Dot? Polka Dot's got all the dots that can
do.
Polka Dot can do, he's got hundreds of weapons on him.
it's just one weapon. It's polka dots.
Bloodsport
pulls off all the different kinds of weapons.
Mandals. I think of the script.
The mandals weapon that he wears in the movie?
Oh, come on. Leave those mandals.
I was editing a scene yesterday, Idris, and I noticed for the first time that you're going up the side of a wall in your mandals. He always was. I guess he was always wearing his mandals in that scene. Always. I just never noticed till yesterday.
Daniela loves those mandals, don't you, Daniela?
Yeah, I love it.
Okay, who's next? Yeah. If given the chance, which superhero would your character like to take down?
It's not about taking anybody down. It's about trying to bring yourself up. You know, spread some positive vibes.
Cena for president after that answer. I'm going to vote for John. That's it.
Which new addition to the squad was the biggest surprise to you?
I think Weasel was the biggest surprise. You're going to expect him to be this crazy animal. He can't even, come on.
Wait till you see Weasel in action in the movie.
How is the movie? How does it look?
It's amazing. It's amazing. Like, really, truly, it's just the most fun I've ever had. I love the movie. The studio is overwhelmingly happy with the movie.
Wow.
The action is great. It's funny. And it's really dramatic in the right places and very touching. It's great. And all of you guys, just down the line, it's just the greatest cast I've ever worked with by far. Just every single person is amazing. It's just a once in a lifetime thing for me. It was a blast to make. And it's just cutting together just completely fluidly. But honestly, I'm so grateful to all of you guys, except for Rooker. But I can cut around them pretty easily. So
he's looking at me every day on the cutting room floor. They don't even do that anymore, do they? It's all digital.
They made it digital for you, so we don't even have to look at you on the cutting room floor.
I just got to say, what an amazing experience it was. But also you and all these guys, you know, the atmosphere on that set was so positive. Awesome. Such a warm, wonderful, supportive place to be. You know, not everybody has been in a big superhero movie, even if they've been Doctor Who or anything like that. So to walk onto a set like that can be quite intimidating. But the welcome that you and everybody here provided was just fantastic. So thank you and everybody here for that.
Leave it to the British guy to come in right at the end and say something beautiful that makes us all look stupid.
That's what I'm here for. That's why I'm called the thinker.
So the showdown champion, I believe, even though we haven't been keeping very good score, is Viola Davis's team.
Damn it.
So you guys, right, I have a little something special in store for you, which we have you guys right now. And everybody out there in the DC fandom universe are going to be the first to see a little behind-the-scenes action from The Suicide Squad.
Ooh, is it a trailer? No one knows. Oh, it's behind the scenes.
I think it's going to surprise people.
You kind of sit there and go, how did they do that?
It's going to be different from any superhero movie ever made.
Ooh, looks like they're gonna work with the army, maybe.
The Suicide Squad. Then James Gunn.
I was excited with an opportunity to be able to do The Suicide Squad in the way it could be done from my point of view.
This one is completely unique. This is a gritty 1970s war movie combined with the brilliance of James Gunn's characters and comedy.
You need your director to set the vibe.
The Suicide Squad is just a twisted fantasy of characters.
Within each of our characters, there's a certain beauty. Within most of them, some of them are just pretty crappy through and through.
Be like a douchey Captain America.
The guy who believes in peace at any cost, no matter how many people he needs to kill along the way.
Okay, I got it.
Don't ever settle back like you think you know where this is going, because you don't. As soon as you have some sense about what's about to happen next, James comes in.
Oh!
Everyone mouths exploding, genitals, heads, arms, legs.
It's like a big, massive graphic novel brought to life.
This is by far the biggest movie I've ever made.
I don't think that you know what to expect.
Don't get too attached. This has been truly...
There are a lot of characters. They're going to kill later.
Most exciting journey of my life making this film.
Cut. That was great.
Ooh.
So, that was it. What do you guys think of that? New clip we just saw. Anyway, I can't wait for everybody to see The Suicide Squad in theaters all the way in August 6th, 2021. We're still working on it, but man, I am so excited for everybody to see it. And I am grateful for everyone out there in the DC universe who came and checked out and hung out with us for a little while and saw this train wreck that would...
You're a sport fan. What kind of training did you do for your role in The Suicide Squad?
Okay, so hi, Gael, Idris. So yes, I am a sports fan. I am a fan of all sports, but I played basketball, football, cricket, hockey as a kid. And then as an adult, I did kickboxing and a little bit of boxing. When I was training for this film, because there was a lot of work that we had to do, I basically didn't do a sport. I did a sort of general training package, which was more centered around my kickboxing training. So that's lots of circuits, lots of, you know, cardio work, a little bit of weight training to get those big muscles up. And yeah, you know, essentially working on that particular film, the work weight was so high, we were training every day on the job. So that's me.
Turns out Gael isn't the only tennis player who is a massive DC fan. Now let's check in with two other mega fans who, like us, share a mutual love for Wonder Woman.